In this video, we are discussing data types in Java. So data types in Java can mainly get divided into two categories. One is the primitive data type and the one is the non-primitive data type. So variables can have different types or data types, and they can store integer type of data, real values, or say some character type of data, etc. And the types of data which can be stored in a variable is known as the data types. And depending upon the data type, how much memory space will get occupied against that variable, that will be decided, and what kind of value the variable can hold, that will be also decided. Data types can be divided into mainly two major parts. One is the primitive data types. These data types are predefined, Java compiler knows them, so it is a primitive data type because Java knows this kind of data types there. So we can use any of them when we want to use them in our Java code. Non-primitive data types. So in case of non-primitive data types, these data types are user defined. User can define those data types, and programmers can create non-primitive data types or abstract data types as when required in our code. And it is also known as abstract data type or ADT. So here we are having one representation that how this data types has got categorized. We are having this primitive data type, that means the Java compiler knows the type of this data, it is pre-known to Java. So in case of numeric, we are having two categories, one is the integer, another one is the floating point. In case of floating point, there are two categories that they are double, and here we are having this float. So double is 64 bit and float is 32 bit, that means 4 bytes for float and then 8 bytes for double. Under this integer, we can have this byte, we can have short, int, long. So these are falling under the numeric data types. If you come for the non-numeric data types, you can have the characters, we can have the boolean data type. So under this user defined data types, that is the ADT, non-primitive data types. So we're having categories like our strings, we're having these arrays, you can have the user defined classes. So in this way, we are having this non-primitive data types. That is, string is one of the non-primitive data types. It is there, is defined with the help of the string class. We are having this arrays, we can have the user defined classes also to be used as non-primitive data types. So let us go for, here is the list of different data types and their respective sizes. So integer, which will be known as int in our Java code, will be using int, all in the lowercase letters. So default value will be 0 and it is having a size of 4 bytes. In case of byte, it will be written as byte and default value is 0 and it will be occupying 1 byte of information in the memory, that is the 8 bits. We are having this long written as long, the default value is 0 and it will be occupying 8 bytes there. We are having this short, in our Java code we will be writing this short having the value 0 and it is having 2 bytes of allocation in the memory. We're having this float, 0.0 is the default value and there's 4 bytes. We're having this double, in our Java code we'll be writing this double all in the lowercase letters, 0.0 is the default value and 8 bytes is the size of the storage getting occupied against one double type of variable. We're having this character, in our Java code we'll be writing this one as char and it will be having this slash u0000 is the default value here. So it can be occupying, it can be holding the ASCII code values or say it can have the representations in a Unicode format. And then we are having the size of, that is the 2 bytes here. We are having this boolean, in our Java code we will be writing this one as boolean, all in the lowercase letters and default value is false and it will be occupying 1 byte in the computer's memory. So in this way we have defined that what are the different data types that are available, and all these data types whatever you have defined here, we have discussed here in this respective slide, are all primitive data types. So Java data types can be divided into two categories. One is the primitive data types, which is pre-known to Java, and another one is the non-primitive data types, where you can have the classes, user defined classes, we can have the arrays there, and that is known as the non-primitive data type. Thanks for watching this video.